I often talk about solutions to the Fermi paradox on this channel and how we might detect alien civilizations. Some of those solutions simply say that we're looking in the wrong place. This story drives that idea home, and it's noteworthy in both its simplicity and its elegance, and the fact that we should, if we look, be able to determine if this is a viable way for aliens to communicate using fairly straightforward means. One of the problems with the radio spectrum is that it's still made up of photons, like visible light, and various frequencies can be absorbed by intervening material. It's long been stated that while radio is useful to us, at least right now, it may not be seen that way by advanced alien species and may be largely abandoned by civilization at some point in their development. Abandoning it may actually be a common sense thing to do in light that there is one particle in this universe that even the largest, densest interstellar cloud can't stop if you're using beams of them for communication or navigation. That particle is the neutrino. The reason neutrinos rarely interact with anything is because they have near zero mass and a neutral charge. They just pass right through anything in their way most of the time. That communications advantage is compounded by the fact that they can travel at very close to the speed of light. Despite rarely interacting, this makes them potentially ideal for pulse code communications. The double-edged sword disadvantage is that their lack of interaction makes them hard to detect on the receiving end. You need huge detectors to do it. We've built detectors like this, though. Typically, it's a volume of material, such as a huge tank of water, buried deep inside the Earth in order to filter out other particles like cosmic rays. Occasionally, a neutrino weakly interacts with the detector and produces an electron or a muon in the water along with a flash of Cherenkov radiation. That's the eerie blue light that you see emanating from this nuclear reactor. In 1977, a group of scientists led by A.W. Saenz pointed out that an experiment being done at Fermilab could be used to send pulse messages. This has been done since, proving that you can indeed use neutrinos for pulsed communications. While neutrino communications are not practical or very useful for us right now, that may not be the case for an advanced alien civilization wishing to communicate through interstellar clouds. Neutrinos are complicated, there are different flavors and energies, and certain variations of those would have no known natural source, so could be identified as artificial in origin. But there are other ways to use neutrinos to communicate. An interesting suggestion made by neutrino physicist John Learned and colleagues, linked to the paper below, is that an alien civilization could modify a star to serve as an omnidirectional optical beacon. The idea is to use a neutrino beam to modify the output of a Cepheid variable star. These stars are extremely useful to astronomers. First studied by Henrietta Leavitt and subsequently used by Hubble and Slipher to determine that the universe is expanding, Cepheids are extremely predictable in their variation in brightness and are of major use in determining distances in the universe. Alien astronomers would deduce that other alien astronomers, such as humans, would be looking closely at Cepheid variables. So if your goal is to say hello, then you can modify such a star's pulsing in a way that doesn't occur in nature. One way to hypothetically do this is subject the star to powerful pulses of neutrinos aimed straight at the star's core. Interestingly, this effect may be detectable in old sky surveys, and there is in fact a candidate star for this, a separate video on that star to come. There are numerous sky surveys stretching back a century that could be combed for oddly behaving Cepheids, but there are other options for detecting alien neutrino magic. In a paper from earlier this year by Ephraim, Fischbach, and John T. Gruenwald, links and citations to all papers mentioned in this video in the description below for those that like to dig deep, they detail other telltale signs that could indicate alien activity depending on what sorts of neutrino interactions are seen. If an alien civilization wants to announce their presence using neutrinos, for example, they could simply pulse out prime numbers contact style. If they're using nuclear fusion, or fission for that matter, that would also produce a distinctive signature that should be detectable. The paper also makes an interesting point. If we built detectors to look for these signals, they would have another seriously handy practical use. They could be used to predict solar storms. See my video on this channel about the Carrington event for information on why we should probably do that. But neutrinos might also serve another useful purpose for a spacefaring civilization. They might be good for synchronizing navigation clocks. Clocks are useful in navigation. In fact, John Harrison revolutionized oceanic navigation in the 18th century simply by inventing and refining a clock that would remain accurate on a rolling ship. Accuracy was everything, and in space, that may also be the case, and neutrinos, due to their non-interactivity, might be better suited to it over electromagnetic waves. I think it would be interesting and perhaps poetic to find neutrino communications. This is a ridiculously speculative question, but what happens if we start searching for neutrino signals only to find our galaxy lit up with them after spending all this time looking for signals that we produce as a civilization, such as radio, rather than things more advanced civilizations might produce, perhaps neutrinos? Just a thought. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently with a song stuck in my head after writing this script. Looking for love in all the wrong places, and be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.